Hello everyone, and welcome to Social Dissonance. This is a durational concert. We have a score, it's a difficult one, and we would like your participation to help us interpret it. I have to inform you for some things. For example, for the fact that this is online, on streaming online, and the video is going to be projected tomorrow here and uploaded on YouTube and on archive. Also, because of the acoustics of the room, we have to speak one by one. Otherwise, it will be impossible to communicate. And it's preferable for you and for us if you stay for the whole time. It's 1 hour. But if you really need to leave in the meanwhile, you can do it from the back door there. It's the only door you can use to go out, by giving us some feedback, so we learn from you and improve. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Are we all?
We follow her, or? That's what we were told to do, follow her.
Or are we a group deciding what, how we want to live, or where we want to go, or what else?
No response.
Für sinnvoll halte, dann würde ich vielleicht auch mitmachen. Nur im Kreislauf ist für mich kein Sinn.
So, do you want this, that everybody does one thing,
no.
His or her own?
The problem is that I wanted to stay, but the rest of our group we ordered, we want to explore the documenta, wants to go. That's why I give up here.
Okay.
And I say, very interesting. I personally would have stayed, but
thank
so
you.
Very interesting. Sorry. Sorry. Why are you leaving?
I'm tired.
Of what?
Of the day.
It's not because of what's happening.
No.
You don't mean that. Why don't you tell me your real opinion? Your honest opinion.
I want to go.
Yeah, but why? We need to learn from you. We have to understand why you need to leave.
I want to see another thing now.
Okay. If you don't want to, sir.
Okay.
We would like to ask you to form a line on this wall. And let's say this is the zero and this is the 100%. So this line is like 50%. And you have to place yourself in this line according to how much instrumentalized you feel in your everyday life. So, if you feel very instrumentalized and manipulated in your everyday life, you have to go on that corner. And if you feel completely free and not at all instrumentalized, you have to go on that corner of the room.
Can I comment on that? It's like if I go to zero, I'm already instrumentalized by you. I feel instrumentalized this moment, otherwise not so much.
you to understand why we place ourselves on the other side of the room. For example, we can make questions to you and you can make questions to us. Like, for example, I can ask you, why did you place yourself where you did? Why did you place yourself in the, like, 30% of instrumentalization?
I think because I would never have tolerated that you are taking out my money back.
But now you did?
No, I wouldn't have tolerated that. If you would have one of my money bags there and I would have taken it from you, I wouldn't have tolerated that.
Why?
Because that's my personal, these are my personal things. So.
Can I ask you something?
Yes, you
why,
can.
Why didn't you mind taking something from my bag?
Because my English is not so good, but you. I thought I have something to do against it. I have to I just wanted to show you that I think it is not okay. So, no, it's okay in his performance, but because...
What was that okay?
For me it's a problem that that nobody says no, stop, and this is my...
What would I do?
I think this is my bag, and I didn't agree when I came into this room. I didn't agree that you take it and put it on the floor everything. And so, but it's okay. So I just I thought it would be too passive to just to look to what you are doing.
I took my own clothes and my last slice and put it in my back pocket and you took it from me.
It was yours.
It was your aggressive act towards me.
I thought it was the passport of
it's
another person.
It's interesting that you react with an aggressive act to something that wasn't aggressive at all.
Okay, but I understood you just took somebody's personal passport.
No, I took my own.
But I didn't understand.
But the question was also for your everyday life. So you feel also that you're not so manipulated in your everyday life?
I think you are always manipulated in any way, but I'm trying to be not. So I have it in my mind, I'm conscious about that. So, yes, I do reflect that I am, of course.
What about the other side? Can you tell us what specific forms of manipulation or instrumentalization you face in daily life? Anyone or everyone? Is that very specific?
I think that's a very difficult thing at the moment to say. I think possibly the lady as well. You transgress borders. You vulnerable intimacy.
You.
You.
What do you mean?
I mean you.
Why me?
I needn't explain.
Huh?
I needn't explain.
I can tell you for you. I'm a participant. I can tell you what it's going for. You know, you expect us that, but I'm asking something completely different.
That was very good, what you did. I was impressed But today, you transgressed borderlines. I say that again.
I only arrived there
okay.
This morning.
Yeah. Perhaps you may explain that.
But maybe okay. Someone else.
What that means when you became a member of the group here, of the team. That's your matter. But I just said yesterday that was lovely, and I said that was a good performance, but not today. You transgress borders, as I said, and there is a distrust. You may explain that to yourself.
I trusted the situation enough to leave it there for a while, and then I thought maybe I should take my have another thing back.
That's what I would have done immediately.
Yeah, I understand that. But what about the situation of how did you say manipulation, instrumentalization?
No, that's a situation of distrust, not instrumentalization. At the moment.
I don't quite understand how I become the protagonist of the situation, though, because I move more or I open my mouth.
You don't understand.
Sorry?
Yeah, I can see that you do not understand.
Please explain it to me, or to the others.
Do
the others understand?
Yes. You gave him my but you, I understand you gave him a question why he is put yourself in this line and not in this direction. And that was a question for you. Why place you yourself in this position? From my thinking, it's nothing together this doing. Or I understand your question wrong. No,
yeah, I understand your question. Okay. Generally, or to all of you, not because I'm a part of the team, but because I'm a part of the other side, and the team asked the other side why they put themselves there, or explain why we put ourselves here. Mm-hmm. That is all.
Understand this discussion because I didn't put anything here, and if I would, and if I wouldn't be comfortable with you people having a look at it, I would smoothly approach to you and say, "Please stop." But this was okay. This would be okay for me. So there is no reason for complaining afterwards, in my point of view.
The question now, was why did you?
Exactly. Yes, now coming to this question, I think quite a lot about being manipulated, and I think I'm not, but I know I am constantly. I am because I want to be part of the society. I want to earn money, so I have to go to work. This is already part of being manipulated. I am in this period of time in history, so I dress myself as people do here. This is also kind of manipulation. It is. It affects all my life. This is why I place myself into 80%. I would say, because I'm very proud of being 20% independent, if I'm lucky. I don't even know. This is my point of view.
I can understand you.
Thank you.
positive.
Yeah.
And I think to take the passport out of your bag was not more aggressive than that what you are doing here. Because it's the same, it's the same if I take it out from your or from a bag, so it isn't aggressive. Aggressive is the wrong word, I think.
Okay, maybe I exaggerated, but the idea when I said that is that you could observe something that you think is wrong, mm-hmm. and you act with a similar wrong act. Instead of pointing it out or being mm-hmm. rational, you
just
took something
to see, I just wanted to see your reaction. That was my point. So. And your reaction was very aggressive.
I was gay.
No, I'm so free and left because it's back for a reason. I'm a little bit hurry, and when I will go at 7 o'clock, I must run to the train, and I won't go to the train. And this is the reason why I won't get go. I have wasn't able to go through the train. This happened for me. Usually formed from theater grown up, and this discussion is interesting. And I thought also, oh, what's he doing? Is it my bag? Mm-hmm. No, it's not. Oh, it's okay, it's not my bag.
What is it?
it would be my bag, I would not so satisfied. No. and why it wasn't my bag. So, okay. Huh? The other, but it was a little bit.
What is it? Huh?
And now I say my reason to go, and I say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Happening. So I would like to hear how you felt about it, or why did you choose not to intervene?
I think it all has to do with the context, I guess. Here in this safe space of the museum, I don't really know. Yeah, I don't question it that much. Maybe I should. Because of this camera also.
what way do you feel? What do you want to think?
I feel a little bit awkward from this situation and this lady, and she feels uncomfortable about her stuff and being out and in the public space, because somehow we are stuck in the back. Of course, it's a privacy. I totally understand your situation. And if there have something and we don't want others to see, that's why we put in some the pocket or some. Yeah, I don't want to show you because I want to be a perfect in the public. I want to be defined somehow. So, I also my stuff is in here, and so there have some clue, and you can see. Oh, here have some stuff like okay, they use the currency. They obviously okay, they have a Mao. This guy's from China. Somehow okay, I know you, and you are Chinese, and somehow and what else? And okay, there's some stuff is from where I work, and here have a Chinese and English. Okay, somehow like this. For example, if I don't want anybody know who I am, and I don't want people to see and to get this clue. And of course, we are doing this performance. Oh, I don't know this will be happen, but somehow I think it's normal as well, because this is art and we participate. Everything and, will be beyond us somehow. And for my culture, the balance is, to keep balance is very important. If I feel, I just know if this situation happened to me, what I should I do is, maybe I say, okay, I'm sorry about this situation, and if there is someone don't like to their stuff and in the public, and I turn it back. That's my opinion. No, that's if it happened on me and what I will do. So I think everyone also can talk about what you think about it. I mean, it's art is art, and respect is respect. So I understand art. I also really understand you. Yeah.
But the lady's stuff were not spread, right?
No.
But she said that if they were spread, she would have reacted somehow. And that is why she said that she does not feel so instrumental. Or, yes, you placed yourself there, right? Am I wrong? To be passive, and if something happened here that would bother you, you would want to have reacted, and I understand it. But the question about how instrumentalized and manipulated we feel that we are in our everyday life, I feel that it's not only a question that if we react to things that bother us or that make us feel bad or that we try to avoid not doing stuff that makes us unhappy or something like that. Because even the stuff that makes us happy is a product of mediations that there are in our society. So it's, yeah, I'm saying that because I felt that the conversation went towards the
what happened here and this kind of manipulation, but this was obviously manipulating if somebody wanted to react and he or she couldn't do it because of the context. But there are also manipulations and mediations in our everyday life that are not so obvious, and maybe they don't bother us, but they still exist, I feel.
Wants to earn money is not a basic need. It's a means to something. So you want to earn money because you have to earn money in order to have the basic needs fulfilled. So earning money is not a direct is a way of being instrumentalized or manipulated, that we think money will, you know, a necessity in life. It's not. We could live without money. Do you think?
Could we? The thing is that I don't think anybody here knows what it means to live in. Yes, I'm sorry. I don't think anybody in this room knows what it means to exist inside the system that we already exist in. So, for example, the need for us to hide our personal belongings, or just by defining what of our belongings is personal and what is not personal, I think it's a product, as Danae said, of the system that we live in. For example, the fact that we don't want to show how much money we have, or the fact that we do not want our identity to be revealed, even though there is no obvious danger about it, I think shows a lot about the way that we function. So, for example, I find very interesting the fact that you position yourself very close to the freedom point, but you really needed to take your passport. Because for me, the passport has a very big significance. It means that you can travel, it means that you can cross the earth, but without it, you do nothing.
But that's only because of the society we live in. Passport is also an instrumentalization and a means of controlling me. And getting my identity wherever the police wants to get my identity. So the passport is a very ambiguous thing. You say the freedom aspect, and I say the control aspect.
I mentioned both. This is why it seemed to be a paradox that you went there, although you had such a big need to keep your passport with you.
You say it was a need. Maybe it's not just the game.